Hey, what's going on, guys? How's everybody doing today? I'm doing well. Thank you for asking. About to be down here Michael Friday afternoon. Getting started quite a bit early today because I really wanted to go take a nap, but if I would have went taking a nap, it would have ruined everything. So, anyway, we're going to do some deadlifts today. We're going to move pretty quick. I don't know what I'm going to do, but we are going for the floor today. So, we got 135. Guys and girls, and I'm in shoes. I know I didn't hold it for very long, but if you know my problem with my hand, it started getting it again. I just pulled 460. Please don't take that rep away from me. That hurt. I pulled that with ease. 445s, a 25, and a 2.5 on each side of the bar is 45. I just got a PR, in my humble opinion. And this is where I promised myself I'm done. I'm done chasing the PR. That don't mean I might not try this again, but I'm done chasing the PR. My back is, I say my back with a grain of salt. I've never hurt my back doing a deadlift yet. Oddly enough, I hurt my back more loading and unloading plates. But I don't want to put any more chances on my back or any part of me, ripping a bicep, anything. Guys, I've struggled with 405 harder than I struggled with that just then. the training that I did with the elevated works, and I highly recommend it.
And that's the paint coming off the bar, of course, but that's the really sensitive area right there. And then this one. These are the ones that keep popping open and bleeding, but of course I got the skin off of there like a week ago or so, and it's healed up nicely, but it's extremely sore. So
I don't even know what to do. So I may work my way back down a little bit. I'm not going to do anything stupid. I'm not going to try that again. Am I going to try that again? I'll try one more. Did you see that? Did you see that? Again, I didn't get a total complete how I'd rather get it, but whew, I'm calling it good. I may work down a little, maybe a set or two of something else. I'll clip it, I'll let you see. Let me get this unloaded a little bit. Dropping down to 405. Working my way back down, 315. Set, working my way down. Guys, how did you like that? That was amazing. That was crazy. The week I've had with being distracted with, action figures and drums and my wife's doctor appointment yesterday and not eating correctly, or enough or anything yesterday. And today, Friday, even today, I had a late breakfast. It was like 10 o'clock when I had breakfast this morning. And all I had was 4 eggs, a piece of bread with some peanut butter on it, a couple of mandarin oranges, a cup of coffee, and a cup of milk. That's it. That's all I had. And then for lunch, which I had lunch a smidgen bit later too, all I did was open up a can of tuna fish, squirt some mustard in it, and eat it. That's it. That's all I've had today. So, you never know what's going to happen. That's why it's of vital importance to always get in the gym, because you don't know what's going to happen. So, while I was going, of course, I noticed, and I do got a little blood coming back out. Anyway, I don't care now. I did notice as I was climbing the ladder, you know, even 315 as I was climbing, I was like, ooh, my hand. And then by the time I hit 405, I was like, ooh, my hand. So, doing the 460 like I did, and then being crazy enough to do another rep, that's crazy. Number one, you know, that's getting the PR two times, you know, in the same workout, like right there. And also that hurts. Dang. Anyway, I had been chasing 460 pounds for months. I've been stuck at 455, and even 455 was tough. You know, I've pulled it 3 or 4 times now, 455, but it's tough. It's tougher than what that was. So, man, you just never know. And I stand by, like I mentioned earlier, I stand by doing your training with the elevated up on that rack like you've seen me do in the past. The bottom of the weight is probably maybe 1.5 to 2 inches from the floor. And I knew that once I started pulling that from the elevated position, I knew I was going to get it off the floor. It was just a matter of time. And even the last couple of weeks, I've kind of been off my game. I think even last week, I didn't even deadlift because of this. I don't even remember, but I think I missed a day. I think I missed last Friday, which is something I never do, but I was letting my hand heal. So I've even missed a week. So that's crazy, guys. It's been a long journey. I'm not chasing that PR anymore. It's done. And I'm very happy with where I got to. It wasn't the crazy 500 pounds, but 460 is close. So I'm happy. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this journey. It's been really rough on me. I mean, really rough. You know, people like to judge us that are out here working out and that, and they don't see the struggles that goes into it. Go back and look at all my deadlift videos. Go look at me struggling. It's a struggle to get there. Some people can step up there and do it like that. Other people have to work for it. And I'm one of those people. And it was a long time coming, I'll tell you that right now. So, anyway, I'm super happy and proud of myself. That was crazy. But guys, I hope you get a little inspiration from this video. I'm trying my best for myself and also to kind of share it with you guys and let you experience a little bit. And hopefully it kind of rubs off on you and you do something great in your own world, whatever it is that you do. I don't care what you do. Do good at it and enjoy it and have a passion for it. Do your best. And then share it with us, okay? Some of us out here like good content, good positive stuff, and we like to cheer people on. So ignore all the haters and just worry about the good people out there that are supporting me and pushing me. And that goes for you, bad body, not so fit. Screw all them people. You're amazing at what you do. Go watch him. Matter of fact, go subscribe to his channel, Bad Body Not So Fit. It's all one word. I call him the push-up king. He does all kind of crazy variations of push-ups and kicks and crawling and all kind of crazy stuff. He's really cool. He puts a lot of heart and soul into it. And I want to see his channel climb and get popular and him inspire a lot of people. So anyway, there's a lot of channels out there like that that I can call out, and I have already. And so we'll call it a day. Guys, like, share, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff to the Body Beatdown. That's me, Michael, your very happy, very proud, and accomplished feeling host. Get up, get out, get rad, do it. We'll see you next time on the Body Beatdown. Now go get your PR, guys.
Get up, get out, get rad, and do it, do it!